saying goodbye up there. Alright, so let's have a look around. So we're at 48 feet. So let's go on up. Keep a look around if I see anything. Alright, so let's have a one turn it. Do a slow pan. So y'all can see there's nothing but swamps and pine trees around. That's the trail behind me with the log across the road there, across the trail. This is not a drivable road here, this is trails. Let's see what it does. All right. I can see the camcorder, or the game camera, man. Game camera, I'm pointing right at it. Okay, we're at 3 hours and 24 seconds, 25 seconds, 26 seconds. And I'm pointing right at the game camera. I didn't really try to camouflage it like I do sometimes. I think it's in a pretty good spot. There's an animal trail right here too. Right along in line with my game camera. I thought I heard a deer blow way off in there, but I'm not sure if that's what that was. Alright, so one thing when you're out here in the woods and you cross a log like this, you always want to check the other side before you step over, in case there's a snake laying under it. See, I look before stepping over it, so make sure there wasn't a snake, even though I got snake boots on. Now when you're searching areas like this for footprints or tracks, it's really going to be hard to find any. Because the only thing you're mainly going to see is like a big impression of where something mashed the grass down. And it's probably going to be discolored a little. So that's mainly what you're looking for on a trail like this. Something that looks mashed down and looks a little dirty or discolored. Otherwise, a good track's gonna be hard to find, hard to see in this kind of substrate here. This is all packed down really hard, and then grass growing over it. That's a small plane that's flying a little lower than you usually see them. Alright, I'm seeing a trail right here. I'm seeing a trail right here going up in there. A game trail, animal trail. Something's been walking through there. And then I'm looking at one tree up there that looks like it could be a marker. So let's walk up in there and take a look at that. It's kind of hard to see, but there's something's been walking through here. Got a little bit of a trail going. See, wow, there's a tree stand over there. So this looks like a game trail right here. And there's a tree stand over there. Let's see if I can see it. So I got the camera pointing right at it. There's a tree stand over there. So I keep listening to the birds in there. So I think there's maybe ibises that are loud like that. But he's doing a little bit of distress sounds. Like giving off an alarm. That's probably the same plane. He probably circled around a little bit there. Let's walk over here by the tree stand and we'll see what it looks like. We'll see what the cypress head looks like. There's one here that looks like a footprint. Let me set that down. I'll get the camcorder out here in a second and film it. It looks like a pretty good footprint right there. There's about 3 to 4 inches bigger than my foot, than my boot. It looks like a right foot. And it's headed right up in here. Alright, so let me put the GoPro back on. Okay, I'm gonna set my rifle down. And get this backpack off and we'll film that and measure it. And I'll look around for some more here. So since I'm by myself, I put the camcorder in the backpack, and then I'll get it out and film as I need it. And then I'm carrying the thermal camera. Since I catch so much stuff on thermal camera, I'd rather carry it. And then I got the audio recorder going, so I can add audio in. So I'm following a game trail up in here to the cypress dome, and I keep listening to the birds back here giving distress sounds. And there is a tree stand over here, old tree stand where somebody hunts. All right, and this looks like a pretty good sized bear footprint. Alright, so I'm following a game trail up in here to the cypress dome, and I keep listening to the birds back here giving distress sounds. And there is a tree stand over here, old tree stand where somebody hunts. Alright, this looks like a pretty good sized bear footprint, human looking barefoot. I can see the toes on it. Alright, so I'm going to set the camera down for a second. I'm going to film it and get some measurements here. So let me get this. There we go. Alright, so this is the big toe up here. Back the camera out a little. So I can see where the toes are here. And it comes back here. And here's the heel. So it's a 16-inch footprint. So it's a 16-inch footprint here. Here's the heel, and it comes up. And here's the toes. So it's 16 inches. And then look, here's my foot beside it. And then let's see how wide it is. Five and a half inches wide. Yeah, and that's what we find. That's a normal size to find. Back here at the hill, you're looking at about 4 1/4. About 4 1/4 back here at the hill. But I used to always measure the widest part of the foot up here. 5 1/2 inches. And it's 16 inches long. And it's going towards the cypress swamp here. So let's I'm gonna set the thermal camera right there, right beside it. I got the thermal camera right there beside it. I just need to turn it out. Alright, so now I'm gonna look around. So what I like to do is backtrack. So what I try to do is come back about behind it, around 48 inches. Sometimes it's a little more. So from where that one is there, it could have stepped on the rock, or it could have stepped right in here. Just trying to see if it could have stepped in here. I'm seeing a little like discoloration, but I don't know if it would have. If that was anything. So let's put it back one more time here. This kind of looks like a smaller one right there. It's flattened out and then stuff falling in it afterwards. But it may not be. It could just be looking like that because some of the stuff fell in it. But that looks like a pretty good footprint right there. I don't see any more back here. Alright, so let's go up here and look forward. So with this, you can see you're looking for stuff like this, how it all that's flattened out. You can see like the one branch here. You can see it's been stepped on and mashed down. That whole piece has been stepped down and mashed down, stepped on, mashed down. And then you got some of these pine needles and stuff have fallen into it. These have fallen into it. Those are falling now from the trees. Those fell into it after it was done. You can see this right here where it's dirty. That was mashed down and it's come back up now. That tells you it's not real fresh. It wasn't done. Like it wasn't done while I was over there. It wasn't standing there watching me and then walked off. Because this is already springing back up and you can see where it was stepped onto and mashed down into it. So this is something that was done before I got in here. Alright, so I'm going to walk on up in here a little bit more. Okay, change out the GoPro battery again. Alright, so the GoPro died on me while I was standing here looking at this footprint. While I was filming it and moving it. Alright, so So this one issue we have is with batteries. All right, so I'm filming again with the GoPro. All right, I'm gonna look some more here. All right, so that's a pretty good footprint there. It's not a perfect one. So I'm trying to determine where the next step would be. I'm also looking to see if any of this has been stepped on. That's one thing you want to look for. See if any of these branches here have been crushed by something stepping on it. I'm not seeing anything else. I'll keep watching close as I get up in here. But if you look back, you cannot see where I stepped. You cannot see where I've been walking through there. So that thing was probably four times my weight to leave a track like that. Alright, so we'll move on up in here by the tree stand. So always look for a couple more footprints. If you can find a couple more, then you know for sure that it was a footprint. But that did look pretty good. And like I said, they know my intentions, because I always carry when I'm out in the woods. And they know I'm not going to be pointing these guns at them. They know I'm hog hunting. So I'm trying to look real good through here too and see if I see any more tracks. There's another animal trail going through there. All right, so there's an animal trail going through there. I just noticed something. There's a pretty fresh break over here, and that's at the right height for human to grab it and snap it. So let's take and move that direction. I can see animals have been walking through here. The swamp's got water in it. It's pretty wet. You can see something's been tearing at this. Some of this is old and wet. But then this over here is not wet. It's not as wet. It's not as old. Where something's been tearing the tree apart, getting the bugs out. this is a trail right here, so I've been walking through there. And then look, that snap right there. And I doubt that's the animal did that, it's too high. Well, let's walk over and look at it. I'll give you a perspective on how high it is. This is a pretty good trail right through here. So see right there, and it's pretty fresh break. I mean, it's just been there for a little while. It could be a couple months old or so. But look, that's right there at like nose level to me. So see how the cypress heads, the cypress swamp's holding water here. So you got turkeys can get water here. Hogs can get water, deer. They all can get water right here. So we got that footprint right back there coming up in this direction. There's a good trail right here that I'm on. And then this tree break here. And that's up high enough that it's like something with hands could have snapped it as it's walking through. So I think this tree stand's in a good spot. There's another trail right there coming out of there. So they're probably using that still during hunting season. Could be. Alright, I can see my camera up in there. So I wasn't trying to hide it really good. Because then nobody should be out here for another whole month. So that's pretty good. This is actually, this being burnt off, this is going to be good for the turkey hunting in here. It does have a lot of new growth coming up for animals to eat on. So here's another spot here. So I was trying to tell if this is a footprint. So one thing I can do is measure it for one time. Inches. That one's about 5.5. Well, let's get the camera off. So I'm out here walking on the trail. I just stepped out here on the trail after putting my game camera, the second one, out. So this is not very far from that footprint I found. And then here's another one. So let me get this. Let me get my tape measure set here. So I'm gonna put my foot beside it. Alright, so 16 inches again. It's the same size as the one I found a few minutes ago. So here's the heel. It comes up. And you can see where some of the toes were here. You can see some of the toes. So from here, it comes up. And then the toes. And again, that's 16 inches. It matches the other one. And it's just right about 5.5 inches. It matches the other one. Yeah, 4.25 right there. 4.25 inches there at the heel. So that's the second footprint. This one's out here on the trail. This one's going that way. Alright, so this one. So the cypress head right here. Put my tape down. The cypress head right here, cypress swamp, is where that tree stand is. And I found that footprint and that break. That footprint was headed into the swamp, headed into that trail where I found the break. Alright, so then I came across over here and I put a trail camera, a game camera, right up in there, facing out this way. That way the sun's going to be behind it. The sun will come up in the east back here and it'll loop around and it'll set back here, so the sun's going to be behind my camera this time too, with this one. So I'm walking out here on the trail and here's a footprint that matches the other one. And this footprint's going off in the direction I'm headed. So I'm out here by myself today, so I'm doing all the filming the best I can. Alright, so here's the second footprint that I just found. Right here. And it's going that direction. It's going the same way I'm heading. So I'm going to go up in here a little ways and scout around. I wanted to stop and measure it. Alright, so I think I'm gonna stop the thermal camera for now. So I'm going to stop that for now and switch over to the camcorder.
so I'm still filming with the GoPro.
Alright, so I'm on, I put the thermal camera up for now. Okay, right here's where I found the second footprint. And where my second game camera's right up in here. Alright, so I'm switching over from the thermal camera now to the camcorder for a little bit. I want to get some of these spots. I want to zoom in a little. And up in there is where the tree stand is. That's where I found the footprint and the tree break. There's an old tree stand here that got burned up in the fire. Got burned up when they burned all this. That's an old tree stand. It's probably in that pine tree right there. Zoomed out there more, pan around a little. That's a woodpecker doing that. So we got rain coming later this evening, this afternoon, this evening sometime. Sometime today. So it's getting all clouded up. So I'm zoomed out there pretty good. So I'm gonna get on up ahead a little bit more and keep scouting a little bit more. Alright, I just stopped and was looking at this tree right here. It's like a pine tree. It's laying over into an oak tree there. Let's walk up and take a look at it. It looks like the root part of the trunk of the tree is up in the air. So it doesn't look like it was just fell over. So it looks like when it burned, that it did take out some of these trees. Yeah, I'm right. The trees in there upside down. This would have been the bottom part of the tree up here. You can see how it gets thinner as it goes. And then the branches down there on the end where the branches were coming out, where they would have been pointing up, like the rest of these trees. When the branches grow out, they grow upwards. They don't grow down. The pine trees, so that tree's upside down. So that's not natural. It didn't just fall over like that. Yeah, so this would have been going up towards the top of the tree here. That's the bottom of the tree up there, up in the oak tree. I'm sure the bark's coming off because it's rotten and the bugs are eating it up. But I would say that's not natural. Look at these, where these trees are burned. All the around at the bottom there, where it's real black. That's where the sap was burning. where the sap came out and was burning. So yeah, that tree's upside down. That's not natural. I mean, unless a hurricane tossed it around. Alright, so I'm gonna stop here a minute at this tree. See if I can get my navigation, my GPS, where I can pin this tree on my GPS. So I'm gonna set the camcorder down here and let it film a few minutes out here. I'll let it sit down and film a few minutes. I'll just show you this real quick while I'm here too. I'm fixing to bring up the navigation, but my location, 74 degrees, because I got one bar. Now I got two bars of service, not back to one. Don't have much good service out here in these areas. 74 degrees and cloudy. And it shows you the closest city you're to. I'm closest to Polk City here. And then, alright, so it tells me sunset's gonna be at 6:28. Wind is 7 miles, gust of 14. And the wind's coming out of the south, south-southwest. This is pretty good for stuff like this. Humidity 77%. Tells you the moon. And of course you got the radar. So we got some rain out there. I don't think it's going to be enough service to show that good. Alright, so I'm gonna let the camcorder sit there and film a few minutes. Let me zoom it in a little too. There we go. I'll see if I can get my navigation to work and pin this location. Alright, so check this out. The blue dot's where I am. I just saved that location. That's where the upside down tree is. And the kind of more brownish grayish trees there, that's all cypress swamp. That's that cypress swamp we're looking at right ahead. That's a really big, huge cypress swamp. It's a pine tree right there's been hit by lightning. It's been hit by lightning and dying. I guess usually it kills them when the lightning hits them. So this tree here that's leaning. So that looks more natural. See the bigger end's down towards the bottom and it gets narrower as it comes up. And then you can see where the branches were way up high over there where branches come out and they're going upwards. So that's more natural. So the wind probably did that. I know the roots will get, or the ground around the roots will get softened up when there's a lot of water sitting there. And then the wind will blow them over. Or strong storm, or like the hurricane winds, or strong storm comes through. And it probably blew it over. But that's probably natural there. That looks more natural than that other one back there that was upside down. There's a pair of hawks flying around over here. The other one's back over that way. We're coming back out to the truck. This is where that hunter sent in his email with all the encounters he had on this road and on the Levy Road is up in here too. So I'll get to Levy Road another time. I know I won't have time today. Right, I'm gonna let the camera film a little bit down the road there in case something crosses the road. Alright, I'm gonna get the truck opened up and get me a sandwich. Starting to rain on us. I got back just before it rained in. Yeah.